I'm definitely naughty. I'll tell you now.
Yes. Well, you're here, so you're nice. No coal in your stocking.
Hear the music upstairs.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can hear it outside. That's hysterical.
I've been here for a while, so I guess.
It's going to be a good day.
A-L-Z-O. Volunteer, please proceed to the second floor of the cafeteria. If you are registered.
Okay, am I registered? I guess
so. Once you get your badge, you can go make a left.
Make that announcement one more time.
No.
Come on.
No, please.
I'm camera shy. Yeah. Go
by in the side.
To give you an idea of size, it's more like
No, don't.
We're getting here.
We got CPR classes
going.
Second floor. This is the org chart. Bob is in charge of this block. This is the basket building area. Bob's behind you.
His
captains are in this group. Bob's accountable for these captains to do their job. Wrapping station manager is Amy Ferreira. She's in charge of wrapping and inspections. Also under Bob's group, Amy's accountable for that group. Public relations is Ben from the hospital, and also someone appointed for the chamber, and Bob Kilroy, under Bob Kilroy's group, and also a DJ and entertainment. These people have questions about those areas, managerial questions, it goes to Bob. The second block is Jason. Traffic control is under there, where all the cones are. Dumpster trash removal is Pat Dory. Food service is Ryan at the hospital. Myself, registration, accountable for the registration and flow of volunteers. Driver management, and then the videography, and then that's you. So. Right here, so I'm gonna make sure you get the best shots. Then our observers is Martin from the chamber, that's his cell phone number, and Marat from the rest a hospital. These are our observers here to make sure everything is fine from a risk reduction perspective.
Nice.
Okay.
Cool.
This is gonna be the assembly station right here.
Yep.
You put all the baskets together. They're gonna put them in here.
Because of your hard labor.
Exactly. It's really, you know, lots of upper body, you know, lots of core.
Make it right, Kat. 13. We're going to be out there.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Want me to get on that side?
All right, so why is something like this? First of all, what are you doing here today?
So we're cutting baskets for the Basket Brigade. Bob Kilroy is a member of the chamber, and Meadowlands Hospital just recently joined the chamber. So when he made this announcement that he was looking for a space, the obvious space is us. We're a hospital. What do we do every day? Take care of sick people. So if somebody's in need, this is a perfect match for us. And I am cutting. We're done. Oh.
Yeah, these are
excellent. Happy Thanksgiving.
All right. Let's
you want to do it in front of the Meadowlands banner?
We're ready to go.
Splendor of land, Mary dressed waiting. Like a vision, she dances across the borders of the radio.
Okay, welcome to the 2013 Basket Brigade. We are going to have a great time, and remember, this is not just volunteering to help other people. This is about having fun while we're here. We have DJ entertainment today, so if you have a request at any time, just ask for the let's play your tune. We have Boy Scouts here, we have Girl Scouts here. We are going to do some competitive dancing. We're going to do some cheers. We are here to have fun. There is food all day available in the cafeteria. The Meadowlands Hospital has hot soup, and we are very cautious. We want to stay protected. So if anybody needs gloves, help yourself to gloves. Help yourself to warm liquids. Keep yourself well hydrated. Keep yourself warm. We are going to have fun. You will notice out there, you are going to see all types of stacks of vegetables. There is corn, there is green beans, there is cranberries. All of that is going to go into the baskets. When you registered today, everyone was given a name tag with a number. Look at your number, because that's going to be your group. The groups are going to have the responsibility of building the baskets. When the baskets are complete, you are going to call for your inspection. Now, please pay attention to the contents that go into each basket. It's important that everything that we requested in the basket is in the basket. We have enough supplies to do the baskets the way they're laid out. The Capri Suns, you'll notice they don't get an entire case. Likewise with the Snicker bars. So you might have to open some things to be sure that everybody has the same quantity. All of this is done anonymously. When these baskets are delivered, it's not going to be a commercial advertisement for anyone's company or anyone's donation. We have people here today that donated their time. We have people here today that donated a basket to feed a family. And we have people here today that donated 30 and 40 baskets. So your contribution, while we appreciate it, everyone is treated the same for your efforts here today. And I especially thank the volunteers, because without your help, this would not be possible. What we are going to try to do right now is kind of form somewhat of a semicircle so we could do a little warm-up. So if we could try and arrange ourselves in that semicircle, and I'm trying to avoid stepping in front of the speakers because I don't want to hurt your eardrums. Here,
some of the committee was here yesterday overlooking that flag and the water, and we said this is a beautiful place to have the Basket Brigade. Meadowlands Hospital, thank you for allowing us to use this space. We just have one minor request. When we do it next year, if we do it here, we'd like you to install some radiant heaters up here. We want a little bit of warmth, but for their hospitality, I'm not sure where the
Lynn
is. There's a lot of here from the hospital. Guys, thank you. They've been more than accommodating to every request that we made and we needed. All right, where is Jay? All right, Jay, we need him out here. All right, let's get things started properly. If everyone would turn and face that American flag, where is my senior patrol leader? Senior patrol leader, step up. Where are you? Come on over. All right, if you would, remove your hats, and we will have our senior patrol leader from Troop 17 lead us in the salute to the flag.
Good. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I hear we have a song. You don't want a microphone for this? All right, go ahead.
All right, can everybody hear me?
Yes!
All right, what we're going to do today, if you don't know who I am, my name is Tristan. I was the camp director at Camp Lewis, which is a Boy Scout camp in Northern New Jersey Council. And the song I'm going to sing with you guys this morning is the song I sing every morning with our Cub Scouts. It is called the Live, Awake, Alert, Enthusiastic. I said it's called the Live, Awake, Alert, Enthusiastic. All right, I'm going to sing it for you once, and then you're going to join in. We're going to sing the song three times, and every time we get faster. There's a few hand motions, so follow me. It goes, I'm alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. I'm alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. I'm alive, awake, alert. I'm alert, awake, alert. I'm alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. Can we get back?
Yeah!
All right, on the count of three. One, two, three.
I'm alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. I'm alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. I'm alive.
Boy Scout group leaders, come see me up front here, please. The Boy Scouts to get their group assignments together. I just want to have a little bit of fun here. This game, this warm-up exercise is called I'm Going to a Thanksgiving Feast and I'm Bringing Something. And as many of you remember, we used to do this with picnics. Well, you bring something that begins your first name. So, I'm going to a Thanksgiving feast, and I'm bringing, my name is Bob, I'm bringing bread. What are you bringing? No, we got to know your name.
My name is
Olivia, and I'm bringing olives.
Where are you from, Olivia?
Hasbrook Heights. Okay, what are you bringing?
My name is
Johnny Cozy. My name is Johnny Cozy, and I'm bringing juice.
Okay, who else? What are you bringing?
My name is Jay Patel, and I'm bringing spirit!
Yeah. My name is Jason Sawyer, and I'm bringing hugs!
Yeah!
All right, who else? What are you bringing?
Your name is?
My name is Linda, I'm bringing joy.
Yeah!
All right, without a microphone. Mark, what are you bringing?
I'm Mark, and I'm bringing love!
Yeah! Love don't stop with that, Mark.
Mucho.
All right, somebody else. What are you bringing, young man?
He goes,
my name is Jason, and I'm bringing baskets.
All right, let's break up into our groups. What we are going to do, the Boy Scouts have large numbers, they're going to hold them up. What I'd like to do is there's going to be 10 different groups. Now there's some question about those people who do not have a group number. If you do not have a group number, stick around the center because you have the distinct privilege of being the floater. That means you get to do whatever we need you to do. And we also didn't give anybody the T. You know what the T station is? Who knows what the T station might be? The turkey station. We didn't want to call any of you turkeys, so we didn't give you T's. But there are turkeys here. The people are going to need to wrap turkeys. All right, now. So, Boy Scouts, where are we? I would like to do this. Go outside there. Start with number 1, 2, 3. All right, they already did it. People, please take a look at your badge. If you have a number 1, find the guy over here that says number 1. Number 2 is over there. Number 3 is behind us. We are going to give you instructions all day. Don't worry, this is not complicated. But you are going to be helping so many people today. I see number 4. He's alone. Where are all the number 4 people? All right, there's our number 4 people. Wave, number 4s. Yeah, where's number 5? Number 5, come on, wave at us. Who's this poor guy over here? He's got 2 people. There are more than 2 number 5s here, I know it. Number 6, so you guys are all number 6s, are you? All right, I see a number 4. You know, we're going to play a little game. Who came the furthest? If anybody, who came the furthest? How many of you came from Hudson County? This is Hudson County that we're in. Not very far, sorry, because the guys from Bergen County came further. Who's here from Bergen County? Raise your hand. All right, there are a few people from Bergen County. Burlington County. All right.
What up? Yeah.
Where's Burlington County?
Come on.
All right, who's further out than Burlington County? Maybe Camden County. Atlantic County. All right, who's not from the state of New Jersey here? I know I met a few people. Come on over here. Where are you from?
New York.
New York. All right, there you go. Now we got to cross the river. Not a good day for swimming today, I don't think. All right, but wait a minute. I think I was introduced someplace around here to a marathon runner who is from Japan. Who comes further than Japan? Anybody? Here he is. He's a marathon runner. Tell us a little bit about what brought you here today and the marathons that you've been running in.
Yeah, I finished the New York City Marathon in last 2 weeks. And next I go to the Orlando, Florida, Disney World, Marathon too. I try to do it my best.
Good for you and thank you. You notice that. He's here today to feel the little bit of chill and then he's leaving us and going to Orlando, Florida where it's nice and warm. I met somebody else earlier. Good morning, everybody! I need to hear it back. I need some energy back. So when I say good morning, I need even louder back. Is that okay? Okay. Good morning!
Good morning!
That's still not loud enough. One more time. Good morning! I love it. I love it. I love it. This is what we're going to do for a warm-up game. Everyone in their group is going to be doing the human knot game. This is a warm-up. Where's group number 1? Raise your hand. I need a cheer from group number 1. I need to hear group number 1. Where's group number 1? All right, now same for the rest of the groups. Where is group number 2? I need to hear you. There we are, group number 3. There we go. Let's see who's the loudest. I need group number 4. Where are you? I can't hear you, 4. Go again. Number 4? There we are.
that completed, we'll get the list. So your goal is to finish the game we're about to do to get the list. Is everyone holding hands? It looks like we got that. Okay, I want everyone to watch. Leslie, what's the name of your group? Number four. Group number four is gonna demonstrate the human knot as my instructions. Okay, so you guys can watch group number four. Everyone look at group number four. Group number four, everyone put only your left hand in the middle. Put your left hand in the middle and grab a random hand not next to you. Grab a random hand not next to you. Great. Now, put your right hand in the middle and grab another random hand not next to you. Now, it is your turn to untie your human knot without breaking any hands. Here we go, this is a warm-up game. So go ahead and try, group number four. Keep on going. You're gonna be going underneath people, stepping over people, and this is how we are starting our day and practicing our team building skills. And there they begin. And here.
All right, so.
Caution tape behind the chairs. We want all the wrap baskets there.
You wanna take over the mic for me? Amy.
Thank you.
come to...
Welcome to the Meadowlands Basket Brigade.
Numbers are hearing things have an issue. Chase was trying to track it for real. Pitfall is here. But home markets and hospital knows we have to have a big trade on play moves. Pat Dorsey's doing a great job with trash and dumpster and trash removal. Ryan Hospital Food Service. Question Leah goes that way. Registration is Rebecca and Martin, that's basically done. Registration is no more. Driver manager is Ada Command, videography is Moroccan Hospital. Observers, Chambers is Martin there, and Morant there at the hospital.
Yeah, technically,
okay, alright, awesome. So I just want to understand, that's my pitfall, and Jason and Bob and I were talking about it. And taking the traffic to the flow, just using that.
Alright, so did you think about what your issue is? The biggest issue?
The biggest issue is when 20 cars come at the same time, or 30 cars come at the same time, they load, they start cleaning their cars, and
you know, make mistakes. So what if we do make sure that gets done in the lower part?
Yeah. That's probably
So you don't go up the ramp. So you're ready to book. There's no fix your truck now. Fix your truck in the parking lot.
Yeah.
Ready to go? Yeah. Drive up.
Great. So we're going to have a driver meeting on that. So we're going to have a driver meeting. And the driver meeting, we'll make sure those...
They get their list of addresses, right. They load their car, and off they go.
Right.
Right? Okay.
Right. They get the route, and drivers need to be pedestrian safety, just to get alert for that.
If you keep all of that down the lower parking lot, you won't have traffic control issues on top.
Okay. We're also going to have on the ramp two people here and two people here. Okay. Be okay. I understand this ramp is a little steep, so these people just got to know Jason has a plan, but we're just going to touch base.
Okay, good morning. Okay. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning,
everybody.
Happy Basket Brigade 2013.
All people here are registered to be drivers. Okay, so we have the driver routes. What we're gonna go over.
Thank you. So these are all the drivers. If you're a driver, raise your hand. Great. Everyone here who just raised your hand, you are registered to be a driver. Is that right? When you register. If you do not register to be a driver, you wanna be a driver, let Renee know here and Lauren know here, and they'll make sure you get on a route. Okay? All right, so this is what we're gonna go through. We're gonna go over the driver protocol when we deliver the baskets. We're gonna go over traffic safety for going up the ramp, and then we're going to talk about how to load the baskets, okay? The first thing is,
clean truck.
For traffic safety, I'm gonna pass the mic to Jason.
Hey, how you doing?
First things first, when you bring up your truck, make sure your truck is ready to accept deliveries. We don't want you to come up here and start cleaning out your truck. Clean out your truck in the driveway, so when you come up here, we'll just load you up and send you packing. Number two.
See her. When your vehicle comes up, you want to go all the way to the end first, right? And we queue up. Okay, so there's going to start being a queue. Drivers, we need to be concerned for pedestrian safety. Keep your eyes open for that. Eyes open. So we have an intersection of drivers coming up this ramp and people walk around putting baskets. So we need to keep an eye out for that. Jason will have two people stationed on that end of the ramp and that end of the ramp to stop traffic going in and out. Okay?
We're going to have five trucks at a time come up. So you're going to meet at the beginning.
Meet at the beginning of the ramp. We're going to call up five trucks, load them up, and then we're going to call five more trucks up. This way, we want to be safe. We don't want anybody hurt. We want you all to come back next year. So safety is very important. Even though we're at the hospital, we don't want to use it.
So next,
we're going to do some role playing.
Bonnie or Goldwyn like we did last year. We're going to be giving the list to everybody right after this little huddle here. So, Jason knocks on the door. Okay, go. Jason has a route and knocks on this door in Secaucus, New Jersey. He's got the basket. The family does not know that you are arriving. Some do know, some do not know. There's an element of surprise. That's the beauty of this. You get to have the gift of giving. Okay, Jason knocks on the door and...
Basket Brigade. This is a donation from no one you know. It's just, we're going to give it to you, and one day when you have the opportunity to thank someone else and you can help someone else, just pay it forward. Happy Thanksgiving.
I don't know what to say. I really wasn't expecting this. Are you sure you don't have someone else you'd like to give this to?
No, Bob. Bob, we're going to give it to you because we love you.
Well, thank you.
It's the happy dance.
Happy dance with my DJ. But thank you very much. I can't believe this. And who do I have to thank for this?
You don't have to thank anybody. The Meadowlands Chamber of Commerce put this together along with the contractors and building services. We assembled it at the Meadowlands Hospital. And other than that, there isn't anybody except 150 volunteers that helped support our community.
Thank you. Thank you. I don't know how to say thank you. And believe me, when you deliver this, I've had this experience. When you deliver this to the door, they will not know how to say thank you. Some of them will actually break down in tears. I promised my wife I wouldn't cry in public, so I won't. But I will do that happy dance with the DJ. All right, everybody, happy dance. Happy dance. Let's warm up. Happy dance. Jump up and down. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
All right, another way to say this too. When people say, who is this from? I'm just the delivery person. It's from an anonymous friend. So if you want to say something simple, I'm just the delivery person.
All right, we have a question.
Anonymous friend. Question, go ahead. Okay, what if they are not home?
Move on to the next door.
Actually, naked homes. We could not locate where they are when Hurricane Sandy was happening. Okay, so you as a driver have that leadership role to determine if they're not home, you can leave it on their doorstep or tell a neighbor, leave with a neighbor to give it to them. That's the protocol with that. If it's very clear that that building is vacant, okay, there's something not right, you now have the benefit of having a mystery basket and your team gets to find who that family to give it to. Yeah, that's one of the most rewarding experiences. Right? Because now if you're driving down the street and you're on Main Street and you see this family that's just, you know they could use something, you have that experience to give it to them in your own special way. So some of you may have that opportunity for mystery baskets. It is quite rewarding. I've had that pleasure a few times, so it's great.
When you do go to the door, make sure you go in groups of two. No one goes up to the door alone. You go up in a group of two. Everybody get that? One, two. So you all get to share the experience. Right, Brooke?
Yes. All drivers will get a route soon. On there, there's a phone number. If you need any help, that is a phone number. And that call goes to Eric. Where's Eric? Eric right there. He made the family list. He made the routes with his team there. So he will field any questions you have. The lists just have addresses. If you do not have a GPS, figure out how maps.google.com works on your phone, or make sure someone on your team has a GPS. Back in the day, 10 years ago, when these brigades happened, we had something called MapQuest, right? And we would pick routes. We don't need to do that anymore. So, but if you have any issues, Eric will be here to do that. Right, and if you have issues... Okay, if you sign up to deliver, you do not have a partner. There are people here who did not sign to deliver, but so we're going to create buddies, okay? So usually at the end, somebody's like, oh, I want to deliver. And you raise your hand if you are a driver, you know, the partner, and you can pair up with somebody else, okay? Because we always want to go groups of two at a minimum, okay?
All right, everybody filter in. Volunteers so that we know who is here. We identify this picture next year, so we know who to call you back.
Andy's got to be the photo too. Dan, you've been spinning tunes all day. Cool. All right, let's get this picture done. All right, on the count of three, I want to hear Basket Brigade. 1, 2, 3.
One more time.
One more time. All right, 1, 2. DJ's outside. All right, 1, 2, 3. Dan, can we get you to kill the music? Turn the music off first. All right, here we go. We're going to get this on tape. Jay is going to lead us in a cheer. Okay, this is what we're going to do. We're going to do an old scout cheer. So, Edie Shapiro, raise your hand. This is the center of line. From Edie Shapiro to your right is group one. From Edie Shapiro to your left is group two. So if you're group one, raise your hand. Raise your hand, group one. If you're group two, raise your hand.
You're not sure, Rachel.
Very good. So, we're going to practice two times, and then we're going to do it for real. All right? Are we ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Basket!
No, I didn't point up. So it's going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, brigade. Okay?
Louder.
All right, here we go. Raise your hands up, okay? We got that? Is that a good time shot?
Yep.
You like that? Okay. Very good. Here we're going to go. This is for real. And what I need to make sure that here we are on this Sunday morning, we need to wake up all the other people who are still sleeping in and make sure the people who are working at the New Meadowlands Grandstand and in the Meadowlands right there and people at MetLife Stand can hear us, okay? Let's make it loud so they can all hear us. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Up to the ramp. When you come up, you're going to pick up your basket, you're going to get a turkey, you're going to get a pie, go out and deliver. Thank you and good luck. Have a great Thanksgiving.
Drivers to your cars.
Drivers to your cars. Drivers, hold on a minute. One more time. Drivers to your cars. Drivers to your cars.
Especially in this area, today's event is going to enable a lot of folks to have a really happy Thanksgiving. Something they're probably going to have whatever.
And what do you think the importance is of having events like this?
You should get in there.
Well, there's a couple of things. Number one is getting
turkeys. How many? How many? 9 turkeys, 1 pie. Stop right there.
Pulling up and turning.
See my belly, right?
No. So, to be fair, square your shoulders a little bit more this way.
That?
The other way. A little more that way. Good, good, good. Perfect, perfect. All right. So, so if someone were to thinking about, first of all, tell me what happened here today. Let's just do that. Just a warm up a little bit, Kat. What happened here today?
Today, a movement happened. A movement happened of nearly 200 volunteers to make Thanksgiving meals for 300 families in need in the Meadowlands region. It is a movement. All these people came together, and an incredible thing is happening right now. Right now, we have over 100 drivers delivering these meals anonymously to a family's doorstep. And it's a beautiful thing. They get to have the gift of giving, and a magical thing will happen on Thanksgiving. And I'm sure everyone who's part of this will sit back and had the feeling on the day of Thanksgiving, like, wow, we had an opportunity to be a part of feeding 300 families in the Meadowlands region. It will feel good.
Awesome. So without going like this, hitting your stomach, just because of the microphone on it, give us the call to action for next year. Why, you know, let's pretend I'm on the shelf,
yep.
I'm on the fence, rather. And I'm debating on whether to come. Why should I come to next year's event?
Join the movement. It has turned into a movement of so many people involved. There are not that many experiences in the chamber where your family can do something for another family in need, and at the same time meet other members of the chamber and their families doing a good thing together. Be a part of the movement. Meet people in different ways and contribute in this very unique way in the chamber.
Excellent. How does someone become involved?
To get involved, you go to MeadowlandsBasketBrigade.com. We're always raising money to support these families in the Meadowlands region. Every year, the Sunday before Thanksgiving, the Meadowlands Basket Brigade will take place. So save it on your calendar every single year. Recap what I just said. Why I give. I give. What happens?
So why do you do this?
when you give without expecting anything in return, you give it with your heart, the rewards far outpace anything you can imagine.
Okay.
Ask the question again.
Yeah. Why do you do this?
When you give from your heart and you contribute, the rewards you get far outpace anything you can imagine. The feeling you get when delivering that basket to that family in need is one of the most rewarding experiences. I had that experience many years ago. And that experience is a wonderful feeling. So for me to share that experience with members of the chamber is absolutely rewarding.
Cool.
Do you want me to look into the camera? Because that's, you know.
Yeah, you know what? Well, see, I'm only one guy.
You're like really close.
Yeah. So what's going on here today?
So we're here at the Basket Brigade for the Meadowlands Chamber of Commerce and the Builders and Contractors Committee. We come out this year to assemble baskets, to deliver these baskets to unknown recipients that are not expecting these baskets. So when we go up to the door, it's going to be a wonderful experience that they will cut. I just kind of lost my mind there.
So what's going on today?
So today is the Basket Brigade. The Meadowlands Chamber of Commerce is supporting a Basket Brigade drive. What we're doing today is assembling baskets that were donated by individuals that will not be recognized. It's an effort that involves a community coming together to help people that really need these baskets. And the people that are going to get the baskets aren't expecting these baskets. And when we knock on their door and they see who we are, they're just going to be blown away. The amount of emotion when you're helping somebody in need is just it's a tremendous feeling, and we're doing that today. We have over 100 volunteers here. They're out there, if you can hear the noise, doing the assembly party right now. They're gonna have turkey, stuffing, all the fixings for a Thanksgiving dinner, and we're gonna deliver over 300 baskets this year.
So tell me, like, how this whole thing started.
Well, this whole thing started, the Basket Brigade actually runs itself. We were in a meeting for the Builders and Contractors Services, and after Sandy, we decided that we wanted to do something to help the community. Our goal was to do maybe 50 baskets last year, and with the outcry of support and need, we did over 600 baskets to 600 families last year, which was just a tremendous outcry of support from the community, from the chamber. Everybody got involved, and it just became a big party, and it just blew up. So, very, very cool.
Why should somebody get involved with something like this?
You should get involved in something like this just for the fact of giving back to the community, paying it forward. If you want to help somebody, this is a great way to help. You can donate $42 and feed a family for Thanksgiving. You can come out, just donate your time, assemble the baskets. We really have a good time doing it. Each individual gets involved in the whole entire process. Turkeys, it's just a lot of fun. It's a feel-good thing to do, and it's just, we do it because it feels good. It just makes you feel good.
Yeah, I see a lot of kids here, families. Tell me about that.
A lot of kids, a lot of families. People from the chamber have brought their families together. So it's a good thing to teach your kids, be able to give back to the community, give them a little sense of giving to the community, where they're not just sitting around playing video games all day. So they bring them out, even in the cold weather. They're all bundled up and they're having fun. I don't think anybody really realizes that it's 22 degrees out today.
Awesome. Anything else you want to add?
No, I just want to thank the Meadowlands Hospital for allowing us to host this event. And we will be having one next year. And I think that if anybody's looking to do something good and help the community, this is a great way to do it.
Awesome. Thanks. So what's happening here today?
Today, we're gathered here today for an international movement, the Basket Brigade.
Start over.
Okay.
Today we're here for an international movement of the Basket Brigade. This is being done all around the world. We here at the Meadowlands are doing it to help the people in our community. Today they're building baskets to feed a family for Thanksgiving. The baskets include everything that you can think of on a traditional Thanksgiving Day meal. It is mashed potatoes and stuffing and green beans and corn and cranberries and gravy. Additionally, they're going to get a turkey and they're going to get a frozen fruit pie. We're going to at the end of this, after all the baskets are built and assembled, we're going to have a parade of cars coming through this deck, and we are going to load those cars, and those people are going to be dispatched out to deliver them to families. Close to 400 families in the Meadowlands regional area will receive an anonymous gift of a Thanksgiving Day meal. Inside the basket will be a little note that says this is anonymously donated to you, and all we ask is that when you're on your feet, that you pay it forward. Do a kind act for someone else. That's all we ask. The baskets are paid for by many of the companies throughout the Meadowlands region. Some people donated their time just to come here today and build these baskets. Other people donated $42 to sponsor a family for all the contents of the basket, while some donated 3, 4, 5 baskets, others donated 30 and 40 baskets. So the act of kindness, the gift of giving, is alive and well. I was fortunate enough never to have to worry about where my next meal was coming from, and that is what we're trying to do for these people, that they're not worrying about where their Thanksgiving Day meal is coming from. We're here to have fun, we're here to do some good community service, and we're here to pay tribute to those people who need it.
Fantastic. Why is this, what makes this so special?
I feel really great about doing this. I feel, you know what, it's always nice. You feel a special reward by giving back. You know, I did this, the first time I ever got involved in a basket brigade was last year. We did this, and I remember we were doing it to help out devastated families from the victims of Sandy. I came here, I built the basket, I had some fun doing it. I brought my wife, I brought my children. We had a great time as a family doing this. But then most rewarding, we took baskets in our car and we delivered it. And I remember, and I will never forget, the door. I knocked on a door, a woman answered. She had maybe a 4-year-old and maybe a 6-year-old child standing by her side. It was a single woman. We could see all the contents of her house stacked up taller than I am outside on the curb. We knock on this door, she opens the door, and we give her the basket, and we said, we just want you to have a nice Thanksgiving. This is something to help you through your tough time. And the woman started crying. A little 4-year-old boy said to her, "Mommy, what are you crying for?" She said, "It was the best thing that anyone's ever did for me since this storm hit." So, you know, just that in mind, I would do this over and over again. I would love to do it multiple times. You wish you could help everybody, but you can't. It's like starfish on the beach. You pick them up, you throw them in. There's some you're not going to be able to help, but for those that you throw back in, you've helped them, and this is all about. We wish we could do more, but we do what we can do.
Great. I see not just adults here, but there's kids and there's entire families here. Tell me about that.
Oh, yeah. You know what? People get involved in all aspects. We have Boy Scouts. We have Girl Scouts. We have community organizations. We have, I think, a church group here. And then we have people that just got together with their families. We have children as young as 3 or 4 years old here. They will carry a can of corn or a can of box of stuffing, and they'll feel like they really contributed. And they did. They contributed just as much as the big heavyset guy that's carrying around the cases of corn and the cases of sweet potatoes, which are a little bit heavy. You know, the guys breaking up the boxes, everybody contributes. Myself, I have my wife, I have my son, my daughter. Each of them brought their boyfriend and girlfriend with them. So it's really a family time, and I couldn't say enough about this.
All right, so Bob, you have this one opportunity, a plea for next year, either helping in any way, financially, coming down here, setting up a group or something, go for it.
Well, next year when we do this basket brigade, we need volunteers. We need volunteers to help us the day before to get the steering committee up and running and set up. We need volunteers the day of. This is a party that we're having here today. This is not work. But we also need those people that can't make it here, that want to sit behind the scenes. We need you to donate a basket. And if you can't donate the $42 that the basket cost, donate a half a basket. Find a partner. dedicated to a loved one, someone who, in someone's memory, could donate that basket. Do something. Every little bit helps. So if you can't do the whole, if you can't do the whole thing by donating baskets, by donating multiple families and coming here, then do a piece of it. Select the piece that best fits your needs. And if nothing else, donate one can to your food bank because you are helping somebody. All right, you know, there's another aspect of this that I want to mention, and that's all the corporate donors. There are many corporate donors, donors that gave considerable to this, not only time, employee time, money time, and not one of them will be recognized here today. The one thing that you will not hear, you will not see in these baskets is anyone's advertisement. Hey, it's very easy. I could put a little advertisement for my company in a basket and send it out, but that's not what this is about. So for those people, you are appreciated, and although we may not, you may not see it, we may not hear that thank you here today, please know from the bottom of our heart, we thank you for what you have done. Okay. Yep. From scratch? Or?
No, just pick it up.
You know, as a corporate donor, you may not feel as though you've gotten a lot of bang for your buck in advertisement here today, but that's not true. When you see the look on that person's face, and if you could be sitting around their Thanksgiving Day table, I'm sure that they are thanking you 10 times over. So they know who you are. We know who you are. Keep doing the good deeds that you're doing. We appreciate it. That's what makes us great here in the Meadowlands regional area. Thank you.
So you can ask me a question? You can ask? Okay. Yeah.
No, just... You're like, I'm good.
Off yeah, the pretty good, but...
No, yeah, look at me if you
okay.
can. I mean, I should be two-guy crew here.
Yeah, it's all right. So, multitasking, I like it.
Yeah. All right, so just give me your name, who you are relative to the organization, and what's going on here. We'll start off with that.
All right, Jim Kirkos, CEO of the Meadowlands Regional Chamber of Commerce, and we are here for the second Meadowlands Basket Brigade.
Excellent. So tell me what the Basket Brigade is.
The Basket Brigade is a movement now. A group of volunteers came together after Hurricane Sandy to try to help the local community in need and thought it would be a great idea to put together food baskets around Thanksgiving and then around Easter time. So this is the third time we've actually put the brigade together. And it has just now become a movement where hundreds of people are coming together to not only donate but to volunteer, and it's just such a feel-good moment to help and knowing that you're really helping people that still need.
Excellent. So give me the full circle process here. We're making baskets, so we need donors, we need volunteers. And then right down to the driver's
sure.
type of thing.
Sure, so this involves so much of the community and so many different types of businesses and people and employees, you know, because in order to do this, you need the product, so you need everything to make a full turkey dinner, turkeys and all the trimmings, you need the pans, then you have to get all the wrappings and everything to make this all together, you have to put it all together, so you have hundreds of people just manufacturing and putting these baskets together, and then you need drivers to be able to take them out into the community. Along with that, you have a whole host of coordinators, because this takes a big effort just to make it all happen.
Excellent, excellent. And okay, so now, give me your personal feeling. Yeah. How do you feel about this?
As the leader of a business organization, there's no greater reward for someone like me to see so many business people get involved in their community. I mean, that's the true essence of giving. And so I am, when I come to this and I see members giving up their Sunday on a very cold day to help, you know, many hours of a cold day to help others, there's no better rewarding feeling for the person that leads this organization. I'm very proud.
Idea of the spectrum of different people who are donating and or big companies down to the individual
sure.
and what they're donating.
Okay, so the donations are broad. Some people will donate product. Companies themselves will donate numbers of baskets. So a basket costs $42 for us to put together. So there are companies that donated 10 or 20 baskets, you know, wrote us a check, and then also sent employee volunteers. So there is everybody. There's people donating trucks and vehicles to move to get the product here. You know, we're dealing with major corporations and we're dealing with local supermarkets and everything in between. It's helping us put all the supplies and all the details together.
Awesome. All right, cool. So let's just do something for next year. What would you say to someone who was on the fence about donating time, money, or resources to the organization? They're not sure. Push them over the edge for me.
Listen, but to get you to, there is no greater heartwarming feeling. As we go into the holidays, we're thinking about family, we're thinking about need. If you want to feel good about life and feel good about doing something for somebody else, come and spend a couple of hours here. Donate a few dollars so we can put it towards baskets. This is a movement that we intend to keep going on forever and ever. And it just grows each year that we do it. So come feel good with us.
Awesome. Thanks. Anything else you want to add? Or?
No, again, you know, as somebody that leads an organization like this, it is so proud. You know, this movement started by a couple of guys in our contractors and building services committee at the Meadowlands Regional Chamber. And they said, we want to do something. Do you mind if we try to put something together? And this is the product of it. And knowing that we've done this a number of times now, and you can take 150 people, coordinate them in a handful of hours, make 300 or 400 baskets, and then in another 2 hours, get them delivered to people that are in need. It's phenomenal. It's an operation. It's like a well-oiled machine.
So.
So. You could just spell your name.
Michael Michael Gonnelli. Gonnelli.
And it's mayor of Secaucus, right?
I'm the mayor of Secaucus.
Cool. So tell me what's going on here today.
Well, it's an awesome event with a lot of people that are putting together baskets for families in need throughout Hudson and Bergen County. Seems to be going very well. It's very cold. It's a very cold day, so they're enjoying some of Chef Ryan's chicken soup and bearing it and getting the job done. In fact, I think probably like a record time. They started at 10 and it's 11, and I believe all the baskets are already made.
Awesome. Why is it a good thing for the community?
Well, listen, I mean, talking on just Secaucus's behalf, you know, we have over 200 families in need that we're helping this Thanksgiving. So a good portion of the baskets that are coming out of this operation today are going to some Secaucus families that really wouldn't have a Thanksgiving or a turkey like the rest of us celebrate without an event like this today.
Who's involved to make up this whole thing?
Well, I know I spoke to Bob Kilroy and Jim Kirkles from the Chamber. I'm not sure where all these volunteers come from, but I see a lot of people from scouting and different organizations throughout the county. So I think it was just an outreach to put this group together and really, really do something nice around the holiday season.
Let's see. Anything else you want to add?
Listen, I'm glad that Meadowlands Hospital stepped up and sponsored the location for this to take place. You know, they're a great part of our community, a great neighbor, and they do a lot of good things throughout the year, not just only around the holidays. In fact, just to give them a little plug, Meadowlands Hospitals feeds 60 families a day, 7 days a week in the town of Secaucus. So I don't know where we'd be without them and where people that are out there in need would be without them. So we really appreciate everything they do for us. Good?
Yeah. All right. So why is this event so important?
So the Basket Brigade is giving food to families in need, and from my understanding, it started during Hurricane Sandy. During Hurricane Sandy, our whole staff was in lockdown. Nobody even asked to go home. That's what a healthcare worker is. So when Bob Kilroy was looking for space, of course the hospital raised its hand, and we're happy to do this. This is what we do. We're healthcare, we take care of people. So this is just another day for us. And it's exciting, though, to see so many people come out, especially, you know, it's Thanksgiving, and this is the real meaning of that holiday. So, yep. We're pretty excited.